Hi everybody, welcome back to the craft room. Let me just put my light on. I made this card a couple of days ago and I had a question and a request on it. The question was from Briar, who said, why did I cut so much off? And I responded, I like white space and I also like cropping images off. So that was the answer I gave. I also, while I was answering her, I did think about this rule of thirds. I hunted this out. I've had about it ages, but it's just gives you the rule of thirds. Not an actual rule, of course. You can do exactly what you want on your card, and I think you should. But if you're having a problem getting it to look right, it doesn't look quite balanced, you can use the rule of thirds. And it's just putting your image where it looks most pleasing, and it's normally within the thirds. If you want to leave some white space, you could just use the bottom third, or just this, or these three. You can do it any way you like. It just balances the card a little bit. So that's a 6x6, so using this sort of area, and I've gone over a little bit here, but this sort of area. And then like on a 5x7, straight down the middle. I know this goes out and about, but the main focus is on these three that stand up. They probably could have been balanced out a bit better, but so that's the idea. The other request, the request I had was Linda wanted me to do a slimline card with the same sort of effect of cutting the image off. I don't do slimline cards, but I do if someone asks. So I have made a very slimline card. So if you base the same thing and have a rule of thirds on here, these thirds are tiny. I guess you could have a pattern down the side. I think it would not look balanced. I think you'd need to do two thirds. Same with, you could do just on the bottom, just on the top, that sort of thing. So that's the idea for that. And while I was looking for this, I found this. This is what I was used to use when I was doing a lot of Zentangle. And if you saw me struggle trying to do my birds on a wire, look, I could have used that. Made it so much easier. So I'm leaving those out. I'll probably never need them again, but I'm leaving them out. So rule of thirds sometimes helps. Okay, so let's get on with this card. Pop those over there in my pile. So yes, I've made this card, which is 3¼-ish by 8. And the only, I pulled out a few images, but none of them were quite tall enough. The ostrich only comes up this far, and you know. So I pulled out the giraffe because he is quite tall, and there's no way he's going to fit on there, so he's going to be chopped up. So that's what I'm going to do today. I am going to stamp him in Memento on here, and then leave him in the stamp platform and stamp him again in Versafine once I've finished. The other thing I'm going to do is make an envelope, because I don't know if you've not made an envelope for this sort of size. You can do it on the envelope maker, but you do need to do a bit of chopping. So I'll show you how to do that as well when we get to it. I have pulled out some colours. So on here, I liked this pink and yellow, but I didn't want to do the same as that, so I am doing pink and grey. because why not? So I'll tell you the colours when I start colouring him. This has got a sentiment in it saying, are you having a giraffe? But I don't think I'm going to put a sentiment on. So let me stamp him first. I'm going to stamp all of him on here and colour all of him, and then I'm going to cut him up. So pop that right into the corner. So there he is, so I'm going to clean this off but not remove it again. Not remove it, I nearly removed it then. That to one side. And get this little fella coloured. So I'm going to do him a grey, and I've got red grey 11, 8 and 5. So let's do a quick swatch on these. So I need something that's similar paper. That's similar. So let's do 110. They've got a bit of a reddy tinge to them. And dark one first, so a bit of dark round here. Blending in on here. and the lightest one down through the middle. Dry a minute. I might pull a darker one just to do the darkest bits. So I'm going to have to go for a neutral grey because I haven't got another one like that. So if we go for this one, that's neutral grey 7. I might do a bit of touching up on that later. So in fact I'm going to do it now. I'm going to do it dark around here. And do very light. There. And might darken that up a little bit up there. Okay, eyes. To a dark underneath there and along there. See how that dries. Let's do the ears. might just take that very dark one and just do darker there. Do the same with the other one. Darken this again. Might darken the eyes a little bit. Right, horns. Blend that in just a little bit. Okay, so the pinks that I've got is coral pink, fruit pink, and rose pink. So let's go with the dark one first. Wrong end. I might just see if I can do a little bit of pink. And a few areas just to bring it in up here. With the lightest one. I'll just try and blend that in a little bit. I might do a bit up here as well. Stop now. Okay, I can dump like that bit down there. So let's just. Oh, and I've missed a flower there as well. Leaf, whatever it is, I think. So let's just do that. So let me put these away and we'll get them restamped again. Okay, so. This out again, bring back down into the corner, and this time I'm going to get some Versafine Clair, which is a really dark ink, but it doesn't suit, it doesn't work for alcohol markers, which is why I'm stamping it afterwards. But I want a nice dark image on him. Oh, perfect. But I'm going to do it one more time. Lovely. So I'm going to let him dry because that's a slow drying ink. And get tidied up. So there he is. There's our card. I need to cut a matte layer. So let me get another piece. Is that long enough? Just. Okay, so I'm going to do the matte layer first. So we said this was 3. So 3 1/4. So I'm going to do that at 3. And that at 7 3/4. Which I can't do that on here. So let me get the big one out. So that's going to go on there like that. So he's going to be just under 3 by just under 7 3/4. So, because of the rule of thirds, I am going to run him his neck up this way. So, some of his head's going to be chopped off, and possibly some of his ear this side, but that's the plan. So. Probably get a tiny bit off the bottom. So let's start by getting him the right length, which is just under 7 3/4. So let's chop a bit off the top. No, let's chop a bit off the bottom. Okay. let's chop a bit off the top. So just under 7 3/4. At 7 3/4, we'll take off that much. So by just under 3. So what I'm doing is looking to see where the 3 is and seeing how much we're going to end up chopping off. I don't want to cut into his neck, but I don't mind taking off his eye. bit harsh, Deborah. But we're going to do it there, I think. So we've got to get this to just under 3. So that would be there. So yeah, we're going to lose its other ear. Only a bit of it. He'll still be able to hear. So, did I do that right? Nope, he needs a squidge more off the top. That's okay. So let's just do that until we get it right. I think we're talking about a squidge more. This one looks wonky now. Is it? Yes. How have I done that? How have I done that? It's definitely on the wonk. Let's try and get that right then. Take some time. I might end up cutting another one, but we will try and get it right. And then that will go on there like that. I might have to just chop a bit off the bottom of the card, but that's okay. That's okay. So I think I'm just going to chop a bit off the top of that card. So I'm going to say about there. So I think we're finally there. Yeah. So there he is, chopped off. Sentiment. Pull these out. Where were those gone? So, I want one of the bigger ones, or I could go with a white one. And colour it. I wonder if that will colour in alcohol markers and make it match a little bit better. Because I'm getting through these black ones and not using many of the white ones. So Let me see. So I was going to go with Make-A-Wish. This might not work, but if I pull out the darkest red that I was using, pink, whatever, and colour that, I think I should have gone for the medium one. I'm going to give that a couple of seconds to dry and see if it dries a bit lighter. It's all right, it's the right tone, it's just a little bit dark. But if I put some black around it, it might look okay. So let me try that. I like it and I think it looks okay coloured, but I've done it too dark, so let me just do that and I'll be right back with another one. So there's take two, which is a little bit lighter, and I think it looks a little nicer. So that's going to go on there. So let me get this stuck down. So let's have a tidy and get this envelope made. So I think I'll do this pink and black one. Okay, so this is 3¼ by nearly 8 because I chopped a bit off. So got some 3½ by 8 is the closest we're going to get, I think. So there's no 3¼ on there, so 9¼ by 9¼ is what we want this at. And and 2 7/8. So we do 2 7/8 this side. So punch and score. And if you've got one of these scoreboards, it's not quite long enough, but that's okay. And then you want to do complete 180 and do 2 7/8 again. And then one turn. And what you want to do is line up. It's a bit difficult to see the score lines on here, but I picked a bad paper for you to see the score lines on, but there is a score line there. And a score line there. You don't have to fold these if you can see that where the score line goes. So on this side, you want to line up the score line with this little doohickey here, and then do a punch and a score like that. And then right the way around, line up again, and then do a punch and a score. So we've got that sort of thing. So we're going to fold our lines. As you can see, there's the side bits, there's the bottom bit, and there's the top. So you're going to have to do some chopping around. So I find the easiest way to do it is pop a ruler on and give yourself a bit of a score line there, so you know where you're going to fold it. Fold that one in. I'm just going to chop off the points, and I'm going to stick that down. So stick this flap down, and that will go to there. So you're also going to want to chop this one down. So all you can do is look and see whereabouts you'd want to cut it. So I would say about there would be okay. So I'm going to pop it in here and I'm going to chop that top flap off, and then fold it down, and that will be the envelope. So a bit of glue there, a bit of glue there. And then we'll put a bit of double-sided along the top. So seal it with. I'm just going to snip that off because it's gone a bit too far. And there we have it. I will put a bit of white on there to do the address when I find a piece of scrap. So that's today's card. I hope that's what you were wanting, Linda. So slimline card with the image cut off. Don't know whether that's in camera shot, but so that's it for this time. Thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you next time. Okay, bye.